بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ولا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، بدأنا ولله الحمد والمنة بدراسة القسم السابع على ما قسمنا وهو أعمال القلوب. نعم.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We began, or in the previous lesson, we studied the seventh section of Kitab al-Tawheed, the seventh from the ten sections. And this seventh section, we discussed, or we learned about the A'mal al-Qulub, the actions of the heart.
ذكرنا أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى ذكر باب المحبة.
And we mentioned that the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, in this seventh section he mentioned the chapter of المحبة, love.
والمحبة تنقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
And that love, it can be divided into three categories.
محبة مع الله شرك أكبر.
So loving somebody like the love of Allah, equal to the love of Allah, and this is shirk akbar.
ومحبة لله أو في الله هذه واجبة من أوثق عرى الإيمان.
And also the second category, loving somebody for the sake of Allah, and this is an obligation, and this is from the strongest parts of Iman.
والقسم الثالث محبة طبيعية، وقلنا هذه جائزة.
And then the third category of محبة, love, is that which is natural and this is permitted.
ثم أخذنا أقسام الخوف.
And then after this we took the different, we studied the different types of الخوف, which is fear.
خوف واجب صرفه لله، ومن صرف منه شيء لغير الله فهو مشرك شرك أكبر.
So there is the obligatory form of fear, which is worship of Allah, and whoever directs this type of hope, fear to other than Allah, then this is shirk akbar.
خوف عبادة وتعظيم وسر.
And this is the type of fear, a khawf, which is an act of worship, and it is out of exalting and honoring the one who is feared, ay Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is done in private, public and private.
يعني بعض الناس تقول له اذهب معنا اليوم إلى مكان كذا وكذا، يقول لا أخاف من صاحب القبر الذي في الهند مثلا.
So some people, you say to them, for example, come with us and let us go to a specific place. And you say, no, I won't go with you because I'm fearful of a person in a particular grave in India.
الثاني خوف محرم، وهو الخوف المؤدي إلى القنوط من رحمة الله أو طاعة المخلوق في معصية الخالق.
And then the second type of fear is that which is permitted. And we said that this is either the type of fear which leads a person to become despondent and lose hope in the mercy of Allah, or to fear somebody such that
أو المؤدي إلى القنوط من رحمة الله طاعة المخلوق في معصية الخالق أو الذي يؤدي إلى القنوط من رحمة الله.
Or it is the type of fear which leads a person to obey creation in that which is disobedience to the Creator, to Allah.
القسم الثالث من أقسام الخوف خوف طبيعي.
And then the third type of fear is something which is natural.
نعم. فالقسم الثالث خوف الطبيعي جائز.
So the third category of خوف or fear is that which is permitted.
خوف من اللصوص، من قطاع الطريق، خوف من النار، خوف من السباع.
A person fears thieves, robbers, bandits. A person fears the fire. A person fears, for example, animals.
ثم ذكرنا ما يتعلق بالتوكل.
And then we studied or we discussed that which is linked to التوكل, reliance.
ذكرنا أن التوكل لابد فيه من أمور ثلاثة.
And we said regarding a tawakkul that a person has to fulfill three matters.
صدق اعتماد على الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Firstly, a person has to be truthful in his reliance upon Allah, true reliance upon Allah.
مع الثقة بالله.
And then having trust in Allah.
والأخذ بالأسباب المشروعة.
and then doing the means and the measures which have been placed upon this earth.
وبالمثال يتضح بإذن الله تعالى.
And by giving an example, the matter will become clear by the permission of Allah.
هذا الأخ أراد أن يحفظ القرآن.
This brother, he wanted to memorize the Quran.
وقال أنا صادق لا كاذب في اعتمادي على الله في أن الله سبحانه وتعالى ميسر لي حفظ القرآن.
And he says that I am truthful in my reliance upon Allah, that Allah will make memorizing the Quran easy for me. I am truthful in this reliance.
الثاني يكون لديه ثقة واثق بأن الله ميسر له حفظ القرآن لا محالة ولا شك في هذا أطلاقا.
And then secondly, this person, he has complete trust in Allah, complete certain trust in Allah that he will make his affairs easy for him, and he doesn't doubt this.
ثم أخذ يأخذ بالأسباب، أخذ يراجع ويحفظ في كل يوم.
And then after this, this person, the third step is he starts taking those means in order to memorize the Quran. So he learns every day, he revises every day, he memorizes every day.
وبعض الناس هدانا الله إياه قال أنا أريد أن أحفظ القرآن.
And some people, may Allah guide them and us, they say that we want to memorize the Quran.
طيب لابد أن تراجع وتحفظ. قال لا أنا لا أراجع ولا أحفظ، أنا أنام وقد أستيقظ أكون مثل شيخ الإسلام، أحفظ الكتاب وأكثر أحاديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And we say to him that you need to memorize and revise every day, and he says no, I don't want to memorize, I don't want to revise, but I'm going to sleep, and when I wake up I'm going to become like Shaykh al-Islam, I've memorized most of the hadith.
هذا متواكل.
So this person is متواكل, meaning somebody who's pretending to have reliance upon Allah.
يعني متساهل. نعم. طيب التوكل ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
So التوكل, it can be divided into three categories.
القسم الأول اعتماد مطلق وتفويض جميع أموره إليه واعتقاد أن بيده جلب المنافع ودفع المضار. اعتماد مطلق.
So the first type is a person completely relying upon Allah.
وتفويض جميع الأمور إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And entrusting all of his affairs to Allah.
واعتقاد أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي بيده جلب المنافع ودفع المضار.
And believing that Allah, He is the one who possesses the ability to benefit and to harm.
هذا صرف لغيره لا شرك أكبر.
So if a person was to direct this to other than Allah, then this is shirk akbar.
الثاني اعتماد على حي. يعني يعتمد على إنسان حي لا ميت. نعم.
And then the second type of tawakkul is a person relying upon somebody who is living. So not somebody who has died, but somebody who is living.
لكن مع نوع افتقار، يعني يفتقر لهذا المخلوق.
And he does this with a sense of need, as if he's in need of this person.
فهذا نوع من أنواع الشرك الأصغر.
And therefore this now becomes a type of shirk asghar, minor form of shirk.
مثال هذا.
An example of this is
تسأل بعض الناس من أين تأكل وتشرب ويعني تعيش في هذه البلاد. نعم.
You ask some people, you say to them that in this country, where do you eat from, where do you drink from, where you, how are you living?
يقول أنا آخذ يعني مكافأة أو راتب من هذا الأمير.
And he says that I take a grant, or I take a wage from such a ruler.
طيب لو قطع عنك هذا الأمير هذه النفقة وهذا الراتب ماذا يحصل بك؟
So if this ruler now he was to stop this grant or this wage that he's giving to you, what will happen?
يقول أضيع.
He says I'll be lost.
أتشرد. أموت.
Says I'm going to die out of hunger.
فهذا لديه افتقار إلى من؟
So this person now, he has a sense of need to who?
إلى المخلوق الحي.
To this living creation.
فهذا شرك أصغر.
And this is now a minor form of shirk.
القسم الثالث من أقسام التوكل الوكالة. يعني أنت الآن تطلب من إنسان أن يشتري لك مثلا جهاز اتصال مثلا أو سيارة. نعم.
So then the third type of التوكل is what they call الوكالة, which is when you make somebody as a representative or you ask him to do something on your behalf.
تفوض إنسان في أن يشتري لك سلعة أو يعقد لك أكتب يوقع عنك مثلا. نعم.
So for example, you have somebody who acts as your representative or as your agent, and on your behalf he goes and buys some stock. Or for example, on your behalf he signs a piece of paper.
يصح ولا إشكال.
So this is correct without any problem.
إذا التوكل ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
And therefore, التوكل, reliance, we can divide it into three categories.
الأول صرف لغير الله شرك أكبر.
The first one, the first type, to direct it to other than Allah, it is shirk akbar.
وهذا الاعتماد في كل الأمور على الله سبحانه وتعالى على غيره.
And this is in entrusting and relying in Allah in all of your affairs and not in anybody else.
الثاني شرك أصغر.
And then the second type is a minor form of shirk.
اعتماد على حي مع نوع افتقار.
And this is shirk asghar, i.e. relying upon a living person but with a sense of need towards this person.
الثالث وكالة.
And then the third type of a tawakkul is al-wakala, i.e. somebody acting on your behalf or being your representative or your agent. And this is permitted.
طيب. بعد هذا سنذكر ما يتعلق بالصبر.
And then after this we mentioned that which is relating to patience, الصبر.
الصبر يقسم العلماء الصبر إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
Patience, the scholars, they have divided it into three categories.
صبر على طاعة الله حتى تؤدى.
A person being patient upon obedience to Allah so he can fulfill it.
كالصبر على أداء الصلوات المفروضة مع الجماعة والصبر على الصيام والحج وما إلى ذلك.
Like a person being patient upon the five obligatory prayers. A person being patient upon fasting or performing Hajj.
والثاني الصبر عن معصية الله.
And then the second type is a person being patient in staying away from disobedience to Allah.
يصبر عن الوقوع في الشرك, عن المعاصي, عن البدع.
So a person, he's patient upon not falling into a shirk or sinning or innovations.
القسم الثالث من أقسام الصبر الصبر على أقدار الله, أي عن ما يقدر الله سبحانه وتعالى على العبد من مرض وفقر وما إلى ذلك.
And then the third type of patience is a person being patient upon the decree of Allah. And you are patient upon that which Allah has decreed for you, whether it's illness or whether it's a poverty or whether it's some harm.
صبر على طاعة الله حتى تؤدى.
So again, patience upon obedience to Allah so it can be fulfilled.
وصبر عن معصية الله حتى يجتنب المعاصي والبدع والشركيات.
And being patient in staying away from disobedience so you avoid a shirk and innovations and sinning.
وصبر على ما يقدر الله على العبد من مرض وفقر وحوادث وغير هذا.
And also the third type is being patient upon the decree of Allah. Whatever Allah decrees for a person in terms of an illness or loss or poverty or harm or accidents, they are patient in this.
فالآن الله سبحانه وتعالى قدر مقادير كل شيء.
So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has decreed the details of everything.
فالناس عند الابتلاء عند المصيبة انقسموا إلى أربعة أقسام.
So now the people, when it comes to a particular calamity or a problem that befalls them, we can divide them into four types.
القسم الأول,
the first type,
تسخط واعتراض على القضاء والقدر.
The first type is a person who becomes angry at the decree of Allah, or he isn't happy or pleased with the decree of Allah.
وهذا التسخط والاعتراض على القضاء والقدر يكون بالقلب وباللسان وبالجوارح.
And this anger or this sadness and this despondency over the decree of Allah, then this can either be in one's heart or upon his tongue or through his actions.
بالقلب يقول لماذا تقع علي المصيبة ولا تقع على فلان وعلان.
So in his heart, this person, he says,
He speaks to himself and he says, why is it that this problem is afflicting me and nobody else?
باللسان يسب ويشتم ويلعن أو يقول أوف أو يلهوي مثلا أو يرفع يصرخ بصوته.
And upon a person's tongue is a person, for example, insulting, swearing, criticizing, shouting, saying "oof" and all of these types of expressions.
تسخط بالجوارح.
And then we have a person being angry and sat at the decree of Allah upon his actions, his limbs.
يلطم الخدود.
He strikes his cheeks.
أو ينتف الشعور.
Or pulls out his hair.
أو يشق الجيوب.
Or a person tears his clothes or his pockets.
أو يضرب بقوة.
Or, for example, he hits with power.
أو يكسر الأشياء مثلا الزجاج وكذا.
Or a person breaks things like windows.
أو يسرع بالسيارة أحيانا.
Or a person starts to drive very quickly sometimes.
كل هذه الأفعال كبيرة من كبائر الذنوب.
So all of these actions are a major sin, from the major sins.
بل قد يصل هذا التسخط إلى أن يكون نوعا من أنواع الشرك الأصغر.
And sometimes this type of tasakhut, this type of anger and despondency, it may become shirk asghar, a minor form of shirk.
هذا هو القسم الأول من الناس عند الابتلاء عند المصيبة.
So this is the first category of people when it comes to problems and calamities.
الثاني من أحوال الناس عند المصيبة الصابر. نعم.
And then the second type of people, or the second level of people, is that person who has a sabr, patience.
يصبر بقلبه وبلسانه وبجوارحه.
And this person, he's patient upon these problems and these afflictions in his heart and upon his tongue and with his limbs in terms of actions.
وحكم الصبر واجب بإجماع الأمة.
And the ruling of being patient upon these things is that it is an obligation according to the unanimous agreement of all of the ummah.
وأعلى من الصبر رضا وهو مستحب. نعم القسم الثالث.
And now the third level of person, which is better and higher than patience, is
الرضا أن يرضى بقضاء الله وقدره. الفرق بين الصبر والرضا أن الصبر المصيبة يعني مرة لكن الراضي عنده المصيبة والنعمة سواء. نعم.
So the level which is higher than a person being patient is رضا. He's actually happy. This affliction and this calamity which befalls him, he's pleased with it and he's happy with it. So the difference between somebody being patient and then somebody having rida, having happiness and being happy about it, is that the person who is patient, he still feels some of the bitterness of this calamity or this problem. As for the person who shows rida and he's pleased and happy with this affliction, then whether he's blessed or whether he's harmed and he has his affliction and he's afflicted, then this is the same to him.
القسم الرابع شاكر يعني يشكر الله سبحانه وتعالى عند المصيبة.
And then the fourth type of person is somebody who actually shows thanks to Allah. Is actually shows gratitude and is grateful to Allah even for this affliction.
وهذا أعلى المراتب.
And this is the highest level of people.
مثاله.
An example of him.
شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى أراد أن يكتب رسالة إلى أمه من السجن.
That Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah be pleased with him, may Allah have mercy upon him, he wanted to write a letter to his mother from the prison.
تخيل أن أنت شيخ إسلام.
Imagine as if you are Shaykh al-Islam.
وعالم.
And you're a scholar.
وأدخلوك إلى السجن ظلما.
And the people have entered you or imprisoned you out of oppression.
وأردت أن تكتب رسالة إلى أمك فماذا تكتب فيها؟
And you wanted to write a letter to your mother. What would you write?
يعني ظلمنا وكذا وتبكي ممكن أو تضع شيء من هذا صح؟
And you'd write that we've been oppressed and we've been harmed and maybe you start crying and you write these type of things.
قال في هذه الرسالة بعد البسملة والحمد لله والصلاة على النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
But Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah رحمه الله, he wrote in this letter after mentioning the name of Allah and mentioning the praises of Allah and sending the peace and salutations upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال ما زلنا في ازدياد يعني ما زلنا وما زالت النعم تتوالى علينا نعمة بعد الأخرى.
And he said that the blessings that are upon us, they keep increasing. We're still in this state whereby the blessings are increasing all the time.
وقد فتح الله علينا بفتوحات لأن شيخ الإسلام أكثر مؤلفات شيخ الإسلام كانت في السجن.
And then he said to his mother, he said that in prison, Allah has opened many avenues for us because the majority of the books and the writings of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, they were written when he was in prison.
ولولا ما تعلمي ما نحن فيه من الجهاد لأتينا إليك ولو على الطير. ولولا ما تعلمي ما نحن فيه لأتينا إليك ولو على الطير. يقول لولا أننا نحن الآن في عمل واجتهاد وكذا لأتينا إليك. أن يعتذر. نعم.
And he said that if we weren't busy with the things that we're doing, i.e. this writing and this jihad, these things we're doing, then we would have come to you and visited you. Even if we had to fly on a bird, we would come and visit to you.
وسلمي على الكبير والصغير والقريب والبعيد.
And convey my salam upon those people who are older and younger, and those people who are close to us and far to us, or far from us.
إذا خرج من السجن ماذا يكتب هذا؟
So when he leaves the prison, what will he write?
قال رحمه الله المسجون من سجن عن ربه.
So when Shaykh Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, when he left the prison and he was freed, what did he say? He said that the one who is in prison is the one who is in prison from his Lord.
فالذي سجن عن ربه يعني الذي لا يعرف التوحيد هذا هو المسجون في هذه الدنيا. So he said, وكذلك في الآخر صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So he said that the one who is in prison from his Lord, meaning the one who does not know his Lord, the one who does not know التوحيد, then he is the one who is truly imprisoned in this life and in the hereafter.
بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه.
Some people, may Allah guide us and them,
يدخل على المريض في المستشفى.
They enter upon or they visit an ill person in the hospital.
يكون هذا المريض يعني تكسرت السيارة ومات الأولاد والزوجة وفقد المال مثلا.
So this ill person, perhaps he's somebody who's lost his children, his wife, lost wealth, his car's been in an accident.
فيقول لي هذا المريض.
And then this person says to the ill person,
يقول والله أنت مسكين.
He says, by Allah, you are a مسكين.
والله ما تستحق هذا أنت. والله ما تستحق هذا.
And by Allah, you're not deserving of this. You shouldn't be in this state. You're not deserving of it.
ما يستحق هذا يعني هو أرحم به كأن هذا أرحم به من الله. كأنه هذا أرحم به من الله. يقول ما تستحق يعني كأن الله سبحانه وتعالى ظلم هذا.
It's as if this person is saying that I am more merciful than Allah upon you, because I'm saying to you, look, this shouldn't have happened to you. This shouldn't have, you're not deserving of this. As if Allah has oppressed this person.
ويقول أنا والله ما أستطيع أن أصنع لك شيء.
And this person says, me, myself, I can't do anything for you.
وتعرف يعني الحكام فيهم وفيهم وفيهم.
And in another situation, a person says, you know about the rulers. They've got this in them and this type of oppression and these type of wrong things.
وهذه المستشفى أسوأ مستشفى على وجه الأرض.
And he says that this hospital that you're in right now, this is the worst hospital on the face of this earth.
وهذا الطبيب هذا ليس بطبيب. هذا الأصل أنه سفاح. نعم.
And he says that this doctor who is treating you, in reality he's not a doctor, but rather he's a murderer.
ثم الآن لو تموت أيضا إشكال.
And also he says if you die, then this is also a problem.
لأن الآن ما يجد لك مكان يضعك فيه إلا تحرق.
And he says that because there's no place for you to be buried except that you have to be cremated or burnt.
فماذا لماذا أصنع لك.
So I don't know what to do for you.
يعني هذا كأنه يقول لي هذا اعترض على القضاء والقدر.
So this person is as if he's saying to this ill person that go against and speak against and be sad about the decree of Allah.
لا تحسن الظن في الله.
Don't have good thoughts and hope in Allah.
أما من تعلم التوحيد وحفظ كتاب التوحيد.
And as for the person of tawheed, the one who protects and preserves his tawheed, and the person who memorizes the book of Tawheed,
يدخل على المريض.
He enters upon an ill person. He visits an ill person.
يقول السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
He says, "May peace be upon you and the mercy of Allah and the blessings of Allah."
لا بأس طهور إن شاء الله.
He says, "لا بأس طهور إن شاء الله." He says, "No problem. This is a purification or an expiation for you if Allah wills."
يطهر الذنب هذه الأمور تطهر كل الذنوب التي عليك.
And this illness or these problems that you're going through, this is going to purify all of your sins that you have done before.
ثم يقرأ عليه الآيات والأحاديث التي فيها الصبر ويقرأ عليه هذا الباب من كتاب التوحيد.
And then this person, he recites upon him or recites to him the ayat in the Quran and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaking about patience. Or he recites from him this chapter of Kitab al-Tawheed.
يقول له إذا رضيت فلك الرضا من الله.
And
يرضى الله عنك.
The person of Tawheed, he says to the ill person that if you become happy and you are pleased with this decree of Allah, then Allah is pleased for you.
وهذا من إرادة الله سبحانه وتعالى بك الخير. الله أراد بك الخير وأراد أن يكفر عنك كل الذنوب والخطايا.
And these problems and this illness or these afflictions that you're going through, then this is Allah wanting goodness for you. Allah wanted goodness for you through these things because Allah wants to forgive and expiate all of your sins.
أصبر واحتسب.
Be patient and hope for the reward in Allah.
كيف يخرج من عنده لا يشعر قد هذا المريض بشيء والله نعم يعني عندما يخرج من عند هذا المريض لا يشعر هذا المريض بشيء من الألم أو فقد الولد أو الزوجة أو كذا.
So this person who is ill in the hospital, once this muwahid, this person of tawheed leaves, what is he going to feel? He's going to feel as if there's no problem upon him. He won't even miss his wife and his children and feel the effects of this calamity.
نعم إذن أخواننا لابد أن نعرف أن الصبر على ثلاثة أقسام.
And therefore, our brothers, we have to understand and know that patience is three types.
صبر على طاعة الله حتى تؤدى.
Being patient upon obedience to Allah so we can fulfill the acts of obedience.
وعن معصية الله حتى تجتنب.
And being patient away from the disobedience to Allah so we can avoid it.
وصبر على أقدار الله.
And being patient upon the decree of Allah.
هذا ما يتعلق بالصبر.
So this is what relates to patience.
والصبر كما ذكرنا واجب بإجماع الأمة.
And as we mentioned, the level of patience is an obligation according to the unanimous agreement of all of the Ummah.
ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى.
And then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned
باب الرياء. ما جاء في الرياء. نعم. باب ما جاء في الرياء.
He mentioned Bab al-Riya, i.e. the chapter of showing off and that which has been narrated regarding showing off.
وهو أن يعمل الإنسان عمل يريد مدح الناس.
And that is that a person, he performs a certain action and he wants and he intends the praise of the people.
أو يقول قول حتى يسمع الناس به.
Or he says something so that he can be known and heard by the people.
ما حكم الرياء؟
What is the ruling of showing off الرياء؟
نوع من أنواع الشرك الأصغر وقد يصل إلى الأكبر.
It is a form of minor shirk and sometimes it leads to major shirk.
من أخلاق أهل النفاق.
From the characteristics.
الرياء من أخلاق أهل النفاق نسأل الله العافية والسلام.
So الرياء showing off, it is from the characteristics of the people of hypocrisy. We ask Allah for safety.
ما هو علاج الرياء؟
What is the cure to showing off?
دراسة التوحيد لأن بدراسة التوحيد تعظم الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Studying التوحيد because by learning and studying التوحيد
تعظم الله سبحانه وتعالى.
You are exalting Allah.
وإذا عظمت الله سبحانه وتعالى لا تبالي بأحد في دين الله.
And if you exalt and honor Allah, then you don't care for anybody else besides Him.
الثاني من علاج الرياء الدعاء.
And then the second type of cure against riya, showing off, is to supplicate.
تدعو الله أن يجعل أعمالك خالصة لا رياء فيها ولا سمعة.
That you supplicate and you pray to Allah that He makes all of your actions sincere and there's no showing off in any of it.
الثالث لا تترك الأعمال خوفا من الرياء.
And then the third cure is you never leave off doing the good actions because you fear الرياء, showing off.
لأن الشيطان إما أن يوقعك في باب الرياء.
Because either the shaitan, he will make you fall into showing off.
أو يوقعك في باب ترك العمل خوفا من الرياء.
Or he will try to make you leave and abandon the good deeds through the excuse of fearing showing off.
كذلك من أسباب علاج الرياء زيارة القبور الزيارة الشرعية.
And also from the ways of curing or protecting yourself from showing off is visiting the graveyards in the Islamically legislated manner.
لأن الرياء تذكير بالدنيا.
Because a الرياء showing off is a person remembering and being conscious of the dunya, the worldly life.
والزيارة الشرعية للقبور تذكير بالآخرة.
And as for visiting the graveyards in an Islamic manner, then in it is remembering and being conscious of the hereafter.
الآن هذا الأخ أراد أن يصلي الآن هنا ركعتين لله سبحانه وتعالى.
As an example, this brother here, he wanted to pray two ركعات for the sake of Allah.
فلو نوى بهذه الركعتين مراعاة الناس حتى يقال عنه أنه يصلي ومحافظ على الرواتب وكذا، فهذا الفعل نسأل الله عافية والسلامة شرك أصغر.
So if this person, he intended by his prayer of two ركعات that he wants people to know about him, that he's somebody who prays and he's observant and he praises the rawatib, then this is a riya and this is shirk asghar, the minor form of shirk.
فماذا يصنع؟
So what should he do?
يترك الصلاة.
He leaves the prayer.
لو ترك الصلاة وقع في شرك أصغر أيضا.
If now with this same feeling he leaves the prayer, then he has also fallen into minor shirk.
لأن الشيطان لو فتح عليك هذا الباب باب الخوف من الرياء ما تصنع أي شيء من العبادات.
Because if shaitan comes to you with this opening that you should leave off the good deeds because you fear showing off, then you won't do any good deeds.
يقول لك لا تطلق اللحية ولا تقصر الثوب.
He's going to say to you that don't grow your beard, don't shorten your thobe.
ولا تأتي للمسجد وتصلم عن جماعة.
And don't come to the masjid, don't pray in congregation.
ولا تطلب العلم.
And do not seek knowledge.
ولا تنصح.
And do not sincerely advise people.
ولا تصلي بالناس إمام.
And don't leave the people in the prayer as an imam.
ولا تحسن وتقرأ بتجويد وصوت جميل. لا تصنع هذا رياء.
And also, when you recite, don't recite with a good voice, with tajweed, reciting the Quran properly. Why? Because all of this is going to make you fall into showing off. This is showing off.
إذن وصل لا يرائي ولا يترك العمل.
So therefore, a person should be in the middle. Neither does he show off, and neither does he leave off the good actions because of the fear of showing off.
صلي هنا.
Pray at the front.
ولا تبالي بأحد في دين الله.
And don't care about anybody with regards to the religion of Allah.
أو ارجع إلى الخلف مثلا وصلي ركعتين. المهم لا تترك العبادة خوفا من الرياء.
Or go and pray at the back. The main important thing is do not leave an act of worship fearing showing off.
أيضا من علاج الرياء إخفاء الأعمال.
And also from the cures and the preventative measures against الرياء showing off is hiding and concealing your good deeds.
يعني بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه يعني يتصل على فلان قال أنا في المسجد. نعم.
Some people, may Allah guide us and guide them, they ring somebody and they say, I'm in the masjid.
من متى؟
Since when?
قال من ثلاثة أيام.
I've been here for 3 days.
نصلي الحمد لله.
We're praying الحمد لله.
ودرسنا كتاب التوحيد.
We've been studying كتاب التوحيد.
وكتاب الفتن.
And كتاب الفتن from Sahih Bukhari.
وفي كل يوم أختم 5 أجزاء من القرآن.
And every day I'm finishing 5 juz of the Quran.
وذهبت إلى الحج.
And I also went to perform Hajj.
والآن أرسل لك الصور أنا في منى وفي عرفة وفي كذا كلها موجودة عندي الحمد لله.
And now I'm going to send you the pictures and the photographs of me being in Mina and Mecca and Arafah. I've got all of these pictures. I'm going to send them to you.
قال طيب يعني أنا ما عرفت هذه المسائل. قال لا أنا صنعت وليمة وجمعت الناس كلهم حتى يعرفوا هذا. يعني قال أنا ما أعرف هذه الأشياء إلا الآن. قال سبحان الله أنا عندما رجعت من الحج صنعت وليمة كبيرة ودعوت إليها كل الناس حتى يعرفوا هذا.
So the person said, oh, I didn't know this. And then he says, well, what I'm going to do, I'm going to organize a big meeting or a big walima, some food, and tell everybody about these things.
لكن بقي إلى الآن أناس ما يعرفوا هذا أنني يعني الحاج أنا الحاج.
But some people still now they don't know that I'm a حاج حاجي.
فاحذر أن تناديني باسمي.
So don't call me by my name.
تناديني الحاج.
Call me الحاج or حاجي.
أدفع 25,000 وهذا من الحج وبعد هذا تناديني فلان باسمي ما تناديني الحاج.
I've spent 25,000 riyals and gone and performed Hajj and now I've come back and you're going to call me by my first name.
حج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he performed Hajj.
والصحابة رضي الله عليهم.
And the companions, may Allah be pleased with them, they performed Hajj.
وما قال واحد منهم بعد الحج أنه الحاج.
And neither did any one of them ever say after Hajj that I am a Haji now.
بل أن بعضهم قال الحاج خمسة يعني خمس مرات ذهب إلى الحج.
بعد الصحابة.
لا أعوذ بالله. بعض الناس يكتب الحاج خمسة.
He said some people they write Haji times five.
هذا رياء. الآن يا إخوان الذي ترى من بعض الناس أدنى الله إياه عندما يذهب للحج والعمرة يصور حتى يأتي وقال خذ تصوير. حتى الآن أصبحت هناك يعني حتى يصور يستطيع يصور نفسه ما يستطيع. الآن هناك عصا تباع يعلق فيها الجوال ثم بالبلوتوث يصور. والله سيد حتى يعني يحصل كل شيء في هريا نسأل الله عافية السلام.
So this is showing off. A person now going to Hajj and taking pictures of himself in different places. All of this is showing off. Sometimes a person he'll pretend to make dua and he said somebody else take a picture of me pretending to make dua. Said even now a person who can't do this nowadays there's a stick that you can buy and on the end of the stick you can hang the mobile phone and then through Bluetooth you can make the camera take a picture.
يا اخوان العبادة حق لله. تصلي ولا تنوي بهذه العبادة مراعاة احد اطلاقا. نعم.
Oh our brothers, worship is the pure right of Allah. They should worship only Allah. And therefore when you pray, you don't pray showing off to anybody.
ثم أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى أورد باب أخطر من باب الرياء.
And then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, after this chapter, he mentioned another chapter which is even more dangerous than الرياء showing off.
ما هو؟
What is it?
أن يعمل عمل الآخرة لكن يريد بهذا الدنيا.
Is a person doing an action of the from the action of the hereafter, but he intends and desires from it something in this world.
بالمثال يتضح إن شاء الله تعالى.
By giving an example, it will become clear inshallah.
أيام الاختبارات.
The days of the exams.
يصلي الصلوات في أوقاته مع الجماعة.
So in examination period, a person starts to pray in congregation.
ما ينظر في المحرمات أبد.
He doesn't look at evil things or wrong things at all.
يسب إنسانا ويشتم ويقول سامحك الله.
A person insults him or swears and he says may Allah forgive you and pardon you.
يتصدق.
He starts giving in charity.
هذه أعمال هذه عبادات عمل آخرة.
So these actions, these are acts of worship which are for the hereafter.
حتى تخرج النتيجة ناجح.
Until the exam results comes out and he has passed.
ترك الصلاة.
Leaves off the prayer.
وبدأ يسب ويشتم ويأتي المعاصي.
Starts insulting and swearing and cursing and doing acts of disobedience.
هذا عمل الآخرة وأراد بهذا الدنيا.
So this type of person, He has done or performed actions of the hereafter, intending and wanting something from this world, a worldly benefit.
يصلي الإمام بالناس.
He leads the people in the prayer.
لماذا؟
Why?
يأخذ مكافأة وراتب.
Because he takes a wage.
قالوا له عندنا أزمة مالية في هذا الشهر ما نستطيع إعطاءك راتب في هذا الشهر.
The masjid, they say, for example, this month, unfortunately, we've got some problems in terms of finances, so we won't be able to pay you for this month.
قال السلام عليكم ذهب.
Says السلام عليكم and he leaves.
يا أخي صلي بالناس. قال ما أستطيع.
You say to him, my brother, lead the people in prayer. He says, I can't do so.
تعال يا أخي ترجم الدروس.
Come, my brother, come and translate the lessons.
قال بكم.
Says how much.
كيف نعرف هذا؟ كيف نعرف أن هذا يريد الدنيا أو يريد الآخرة؟ كيف؟
So how do we know when a person wants the hereafter through his actions or he wants a worldly benefit through his actions?
عندنا قاعدة نعرف بها أن هذا يريد الدنيا أو يريد الآخرة.
So we have a principle with us by which we can distinguish between a person wanting the hereafter and wanting this world.
ذكرها لنا النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has mentioned this principle for us.
إن أعطي راضي وإن لم يعطى سخط.
If this person is given, he is happy. And if this person is not given, then he becomes angry and despondent.
يعني الآن عندما كان يصلي بالناس أو كذا يعطوه راتب يقول والله جمعية المسجد هذه ما شاء الله. أو في كل يوم يحضر لكم الطعام تقول ما شاء الله هذه الجمعية ممتازة.
So when, for example, this imam, when he was leading the prayer, and the masjid they were paying for him, or every day they're coming and they're giving him food. He says, MashaAllah, the committee of this masjid, mumtaz.
قال اليوم لا يوجد لا غداء ولا عشاء ولا مبيت.
And today the committee said, unfortunately today there's no lunch and there's no supper and there's no accommodation.
قال لأن هؤلاء مبتدعة.
He said, because those people, they are the innovators.
والله صدق هذا الذي قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أعطي يعني الغضب والرضا لأجل الدنيا لا لأجل الله.
So by Allah, this is what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned. If he is given, he is happy. If he is not given, then he becomes angry. I.e., his happiness and his sadness isn't for the sake of Allah, but because for the dunya.
قسم النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام الناس إلى قسمين.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he divided the people into two categories.
وانت اختار انت من اي القسمين.
And you choose which of these two types of people you want to be from.
القسم الاول هم الدنيا.
The first group of people, they only worry and their only ambition is the worldly life.
ان اعطي راضي وان لم يعطى سخط.
If he's given something from the worldly life, he becomes happy and he's pleased. And if he's prevented something from the worldly life, he becomes sad and angry.
هم الوحيد جمع المال أو تحسين الحال اللباس.
So his only worry and his only ambition is to collect money or for his physical appearance to look nice.
كيف يعرف؟
How is he known?
إن أعطي راضي ولا لم يعطى سخط.
If he is given, he becomes happy, and if he is prevented and not given, then he becomes angry.
دعا عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالتعاسة الحزن والشقاء نسأل الله عافية السلام. وانقلاب الأمور عليه نعم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he supplicated against this type of person that this person he will have sorrow and he will have anxieties and the affairs will change upon him.
وانتكس يعني upside down. نعم.
كله upside down.
تعس من التعاسة ضد السعادة وانتكس نعم.
So this person, he has a ta'is, meaning he becomes anxious or sorrowful, i.e. he won't have happiness.
ولا يستطيع أن يدفع عن نفسه أدنى أذية.
And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned this person, he won't be able to repel from him any type of harm.
احذر أن تكون من هذا الصنف.
So be cautious and be aware of being from these type of people.
تعمل عمل الآخرة من أجل الدنيا.
You do a righteous action from the actions of the hereafter, wanting and desiring something from this world.
القسم الثاني من الناس.
And as for the second group of people,
له من الطيبات. نعم.
He has from the good things.
ما من هذا؟ قال أي معنى الحديث أنه خرج بنفسه وبماله في أعلى ما يكون مشقة في الجهاد في سبيل الله أو في طلب العلم.
So the meaning of this hadith is that this person, he leaves his place, he goes out with his wealth and his self, and he does the most difficult of things, making jihad in the way of Allah or in seeking knowledge.
وظهر عليه أثر التفاني والإخلاص في العمل.
And you see the effects of sincerity and purifying his actions in itself or his appearance.
يعني ترى بعض الطلاب جزاهم الله خيرا يعني ظهر عليه أثر الطلب هنا يكتب ويراجع ويحفظ ما يرتاح أبدا. نعم حتى وقت الطعام هو لا يذهب يبدأ ومشتغل بالدرس. نعم.
Some brothers, some people, may Allah reward them, some of the students of knowledge here, you see them, you see the effects of them seeking knowledge in their action. After the lesson has finished, he writes and he memorizes and he learns and he revises. Even when the time for food comes, he's still sitting busy with his knowledge. And as for the others, we ask Allah for safety and pardoning. He doesn't have a book, neither a pen, neither a notepad, and all he is doing is eating and drinking.
إن كان في الحراسة يعني يا يكون في أي مكان لا يهتم بالمناصب يعني ما يريد أن يكون هو مسؤول عن الطلاب مسؤول عن الطعام مسؤول عن السكن أو كذا ما يريد المناصب لا يريد هذه الأمور.
So let's say, for example, you have one of the brothers and he's in, let's say, security, for example. Meaning he doesn't care. He doesn't want to be in charge of any particular position that he feels he needs to be in charge of accommodation or food and drinking. He doesn't care what position of authority he has.
قالوا اليوم تكون حارس.
They say,
أكون لا إشكال.
They say to him, today, we want you to be a security guard outside. He says, no problem.
لأن بعض الناس تقول له تعمل معنا. حارس على هذا المسجد قال سبحان الله أنا أكون مدير الحراس أما حارس ما أكون.
Some brothers, if it is said to them that we want you to come and work with us on the door outside and be a guard, says me, be a guard, I want to be in charge of all of the security guards, I'll never be a guard myself.
وإن كان في الساقة أي الجيش الآن في الغالب أن القادة يكونوا في مقدمة الجيش فقالوا لهذا نريدك أن تكون في آخر الجيش. قال أكون ولا إشكال. نعم.
And also in this hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is that in an army unit they say to him we want you to be right at the back of the division because as is known mostly the commanders and the chiefs the important people they are at the beginning at the right at the front. So they say to this person today we want you to be right at the back. He says I don't care.
ولا يعرفه القادة أصلاً إذا جاء واستأذن لا يؤذن له لأنه غير معروف عندهم.
And also in the hadith that this person he isn't even known by the commanders, meaning that if he was to come, nobody knows him because he's unknown.
وكذلك هو يدخل على القادة وكذا ليشفع للناس يعني يطلب حاجات الناس ولا يطلب هو شيئاً. نعم.
And also this type of person. He goes to the leaders of the commanders in order to intercede or ask on somebody's behalf, and yet he isn't able to do so. And some people they try to do this nowadays with some of the scholars. Come, attend the lesson, sit down, learn, revise. He won't come. And then afterwards he says, "Oh, this sheikh is my close friend."
بالأمس تعشينا سويا.
Yesterday we were eating together.
ورقمه عندي تريد اتصل عليه الآن يرد عليه في كل وقت إذا أحببت أي شيء من الشيخ أنا أتك به.
His number is in my phone. I have him in my contact book. Do you want me to ring him now? I can ring him anytime. Anything you want from the sheikh, go through me. Ask me and I'll bring it.
هذا في الغالب لا يستفيد.
This type of person, mostly he never benefits.
يستفيد الطالب الذي يريد. العلم والعمل والدعوة.
The student who benefits is the one who wants and desires knowledge and actions and da'wah.
فأنت اختار الآن. إما أن تكون تريد الدنيا بعمل الآخرة أو تريد الآخرة بعمل الآخرة.
So now you choose. Either you can be somebody who wants this dunya through the actions of the hereafter, or somebody who wants the hereafter through the actions of the hereafter.
كيف نعرف أن أعطي رضي ولم يعطى سخط؟
So what is the principle of us knowing the difference between these two groups of people? If he is given, he becomes happy, and if he is not given, he loses hope and becomes angry.
قالوا هذا الشهر لا نعطيك شيء من المكافأة لإمامة المسجد.
They said to him that this month we're not going to give you anything from your wage for leading the prayer.
قال لا إشكال الحمد لله قدر الله ما شاء فعل.
And he says no problem. There's nothing wrong with this. This is what Allah has decreed.
تصلي قال نعم أصلي ما الإشكال.
They say to him, are you going to pray with us? He says yes, I'll pray. I'll lead you in prayer. No problem.
قالوا اليوم لا يوجد لا غداء ولا عشاء. قال لا إشكال.
They say to him, today there's no lunch and there's no dinner. He says no problem.
أصوم أنا في هذا اليوم ولا إشكال.
He says I'll fast on this day. There's no problem.
أما عندما يتكلم على جماعة المسجد على جمعية المسجد يتكلم على فلان أو علان أو كذا قال والله هؤلاء بخلاء.
As for this person, this imam now, speaking against the masjid committee, speaking against the masjid, speaking against this person, that person, and saying these people, they are stingy.
لابد أن تكون على هذا. تعود نفسك دائما أن لا تطلب من أحد شيئا. تطلب من الله.
So this is how you should be all the time. That you have to train yourself such that you don't seek anything from anybody. You only seek it from Allah.
وأن الرزق بيد الله.
And that you believe that all of the provisions and the rizq, it is in the hands of Allah.
وتستغني عن الناس.
And that you are independent and free from the people.
جاءك شيء الحمد لله.
If something comes to you, then all praise is for Allah.
وإن لم يأتي.
And if it doesn't come.
تعلم أن هذا الذي كتب الله عليك ترضى وتسلم.
Then you should know that this is something which Allah has decreed for you, and therefore you accept it and you submit yourself to it and you're pleased with it.
ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى باب مهم جدا وهذا الذي يعني يتحدث فيه أكثر الناس طاعة العلماء والأمراء في معصية الله.
نعم. And then the author after this رحمه الله he mentioned another very important chapter and this is something which is very important today that people speak about and that is وهو الباب
طاعة العلماء والأمراء في معصية الله.
It is showing obedience to the scholars and to the rulers and the leaders in disobedience to Allah.
بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه.
Some people, may Allah guide them and us, may Allah guide us and them.
ليس له حديث أو شغل إلا الحكام والعلماء.
He has nothing to say except regarding the scholars and the rulers.
يكفر.
He makes takfir. He calls them to be non-Muslim.
ويبدع ويفسر.
And he says that they are innovators or they are people of disobedience.
ويتهم هؤلاء بأنهم عملاء لليهود عملاء لكذا وكذا.
And the only thing he has with him is accusing those scholars of being workers or agents for the Jews, agents for this one, workers of the of these people.
ولو تنظر في حاله تنظر في حاله تجد يعني هو يصنع أشياء لم ما يصنعها هؤلاء.
And if you were to look into his own situation and his own condition, you'll find him doing things that even those rulers and those scholars, they don't do themselves.
هل منعوك الصلاة؟
Did any of them prevent you from praying?
العبادات؟
Did any of them prevent you from worshipping?
قال لا.
He said no.
أريد حقي من البترول.
But I want my right of the petrol.
يريد الدنيا للآخر.
So this person, he wants something from this world, not from the hereafter.
أول خروج في الإسلام.
The first instance of rebellion in Islam, الخروج.
متى كان؟
When was it?
كان على النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في زمن عليه الصلاة والسلام.
It was against the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
اعترض على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
This man, he rebelled and criticized the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من أجل الدنيا أو من أجل الآخرة.
Due to a worldly benefit or a benefit from the hereafter?
من أجل الدنيا.
Because of the dunya.
إذن هؤلاء نسأل الله عليه السلام الخوارج غضبهم للدنيا لا للآخرة.
So those people the Khawarij, their anger is due to the dunya, not because of the hereafter, the akhirah.
يتكلم بكلام حق يريد به باطل.
He speaks with the words of truth, but he intends and he wants by these words falsehood.
قال للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اعدل.
So that man, Aydul Khuwaisra, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اعدل, be just.
اعدل كلمة حق.
So this word now, this statement, be just, it is a statement of truth.
لكن أراد بهذا باطل أنكر على من ائتمن الله سبحانه وتعالى علينا.
But he intended to buy this truthful word, something which was falsehood. I, he opposes the one who Allah has entrusted from above the heavens and the earth.
وهذا الذي يقول لك الآن هؤلاء الخوارج يقول لك الناس الآن يقتلوا وتنهك أعراضهم وأموالهم وكذا.
So now these people, the Khawarij, who come to you and say to you that the people are being killed and their money and their wealth is being taken and destroyed.
والحكام فيهم وفيهم وفيهم.
And the rulers, they do this and this and this.
وعملاء.
And they are all agents.
طيب ما الحل؟
Okay, what is the cure, the solution?
الحل أننا نخالف الكتاب والسنة.
The solution and the cure to this is that we oppose and contradict the Quran and the Sunnah.
ونقتل الأولاد والصبيان والنساء.
And we kill the children and we kill the young ones and we kill the women.
ونسرق أموال الدولة.
And we steal the wealth of the state, the country.
ويضيع الأمن.
And therefore security and safety is lost.
ولا نتعلم ولا نعرف شيء عن الجهاد في سبيل الله.
And yet we don't know anything and neither do we study or learn anything about الجهاد في سبيل الله.
وتصبح فوضى.
And then the situation it becomes فوضى, chaos.
طاعة العلماء والأمراء في معصية الله يذكر الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى أنها تنقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
So showing obedience to the scholars and the rulers in disobedience to Allah, then Shaykh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he mentions that this is three types.
القسم الأول أن يطيع العلماء والأمراء مع اعتقاد أن حكم هؤلاء أحسن من حكم الله أو مساوي.
So the first type of people are a group of people who show obedience to the scholars and to the rulers, and they believe that the judgments or the rulings of those scholars and rulers are better than the judgments and the rulings and the rules of Allah.
فإذا اعتقد أن حكم هؤلاء أحسن من حكم الله أو مساوي أو حكم الله لا يصلح هذا كفر أكبر مخرج من الملة نسأل الله عليه السلام.
So if a person believes that their rules and their laws are better or equal to the rules and the laws of Allah, or he believes inside that the rules and the laws of Allah are not applicable or beneficial for this time or this place, then this person is a kafir, a disbeliever with a major form of disbelief.
الثاني,
secondly, or second group of people,
أن يطيع العلماء والأمراء في معصية الله مع اعتقاد أن حكم الله يجب أن يطبق وهو الأصلح للبلاد والعباد,
is a person who shows obedience to the rulers or the scholars in disobedience to Allah, however his belief is that the rules of Allah and the laws of Allah are better and more applicable and it is an obligation to implement those rules and laws of Allah.
هذا كفر أصغر.
So this now is كفر أصغر, the minor form of disbelief.
ونقول لهذا أنت على خطر عظيم توشك أن تقع في الكفر الأكبر مخرج من الملة.
And we say to this person that you are in a very dangerous situation because we fear after this minor form of kufr, you're now going to fall into a major form of kufr.
القسم الثالث من الناس,
and then the third group of people, the third type of people,
يرجع للعلماء والحكام ويظن أن هذا هو حكم الله لأنه لا يعرف الشريعة أصلاً, هو جاهل.
So the second or the third group of people are some ignorant people. They return back to those scholars or those rulers and they think that the laws and the rulings that those scholars are telling them, this is the Sharia of Allah, because this person is an ignorant person.
فإذا كان هذا الجهل يعني هذا جاهل لأنه لا يسأل ولا يبحث وتوفر لديه وسائل الاتصال وما إلى ذلك فهذا آثم.
So if this ignorant person, he is somebody who neither learns, doesn't study, doesn't ask, and yet he's able to do this, and all of this is easy for this, then this person is sinning, he's a sinner.
وإذا كان لم يفرط ولم يهمل ولم يجد وسائل اتصال أو كتب ما وجد إلا هؤلاء العلماء وظن أن كلام هؤلاء مبني على الكتاب والسنة.
But if this ignorant person is somebody who isn't able to ask, he doesn't have the means and the avenues to learn and read and ask, and there's no books, and he thinks that what those scholars are telling him, this is the Quran and this is the Sunnah.
فهذا يعذر.
So then this person is excused for his ignorance.
إذن أقسام ثلاثة.
So therefore, there are three types of people with regards to showing obedience to the scholars and rulers in disobedience to Allah.
الأول,
firstly,
أن يطيع العلماء والأمراء في معصية الله مع اعتقاد أن حكم الله لا يصلح.
Is a person who shows obedience to them in disobedience to Allah whilst believing that the laws and the rules of them, their rules and their laws are better or equal to the laws and the rules of Allah.
هذا كفر أكبر مخرج من الملة.
So this is the major form of kufr, and it takes a person outside the fold of Islam.
وإذا أطاع هؤلاء مع اعتقاد أن حكم الله يجب أن يطبق فهذا كفر أصغر.
And the second type of people are those people who obey the rulers and the scholars in disobedience to Allah, but at the same time they believe that the obligation is to implement the rules and the laws of Allah, then this is minor kufr, kufr asghar.
الثالث أن يكون جاهل لا يدري يظن أن كلام العلماء والحكام هو ما جاءت به الشريعة. نعم.
And then the third group of people are those ignorant people, and they think and they believe that which is being mentioned by these scholars or by these rulers, this is the Sharia and this is what has come in the Quran and the Sunnah.
إذا كان مفرط ومهمل وقامت عليه الوسائل موجودة الاتصال وغيره فهذا لا يعذر.
So if this ignorance of his is due to his own shortcomings and his laziness and the avenues of asking and learning and reading are there and present, then this person is a sinner and he is not excused.
وإلا فهو معذور.
Or otherwise, he is somebody who is excused for his ignorance.
في القديم كانت الطاعة للعلماء والعباد. اتخذوا أحبارهم علماءهم ورهبانهم عبادهم. نعم. في القديم كان الناس يطيعون العلماء والعباد في معصية الله.
So in the olden days, people used to obey the ulama, the scholars, as well as the worshippers, people who were known for worshipping and being devout. They used to obey them in disobedience to Allah.
وفي العصر الحاضر.
And as for in this time today,
يطاع من لا يعرف لا بالعبادة ولا بالعلم ويقول أنه خليفة وأمير المؤمنين.
And nowadays, those people who are obeyed, they are those people who are not known for knowledge, and neither are they known for worship. And then it is claimed that this person is the Khalifa of the Muslims.
والله أعلم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. نعم. انتظر دقيقة. أهلا وسهلا. اجلس. يا صح تجلس.
لا لا شكرا. Okay, fine. السلام عليكم. Obviously, you've announced it already as well, but there's one or two other extra little bits and pieces as well. Basically, Kitab al-Tawheed, which the Sheikh is going through, alhamdulillah, the brothers, mashallah, made an effort to purchase it in. Obviously, the proceeds of that will go back to the Dawah again. And similarly, you know, the food that we sell here, that again goes back to Dawah. So all these things are going to help us to obviously fund all this. Because some people think we get the money from the government, etc., but it's not the case. We actually have to fund it ourselves. And obviously, you know, we've told the local people to contribute, but it's not just them, you see. It should really be us people who are participating and benefiting. We are the ones that should be really funding this event, inshallah. So, Jazakallah Khair, just appreciate if you can, you know, obviously contribute towards that in the books that are going to be provided.
And the next lesson is after Asr.
The next lesson will be after Asr and after Maghrib again, inshallah, and Isha, of course.
And after 7 p.m, inshallah, we have a tele link with Sheikh Salih Sahimi. Be
late. صبرا يا اخواننا. الان من الاشياء التي بعث بها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الاجتماع لا الافتراق.
So from those things which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent with is for people to become united and not become divided.
فالاصل اننا نجتمع.
So therefore the base ruling is that we come together and we be united.
نتعاون على البر والتقوى.
And that we cooperate with each other upon righteousness and at-taqwa.
كل انسان بما يستطيع.
Every person according to his ability.
اذا كان في بعض الناس يعني مثلا قال انا والله يعني اخاف اني ادفع اموال ويحصل بها شيء غير المقصود.
If some people they're fearing that maybe if I give some wealth, maybe this wealth will be used for something other than what I intend.
ماذا تصنع؟
What should a person do? What should you do?
تأتي إلى هؤلاء وتقول يا أخواننا أنا أحضر الطعام اليوم.
Come to these people and say, my brothers, today I'll pay for the food. I'll bring the food today.
أنا أحضر الكتب.
I'm going to bring the books. I pay for the books today.
وأوزعها بنفسي. أريد هذا.
And me myself, I'm going to distribute the books because I want this.
يصح. لكن يلعب عليك الشيطان أنك تترك عمل الخير وفعل الخير. لا.
So this is something which is correct, but for Shaitan to come and play with you and leave off the righteous action and the good deeds, then no.
فلا مانع. So أن الإنسان يتولى هذه الأشياء بنفسه. أظن الله أعلم أن جمعية المسجد لا تمانع من هذا.
So there's nothing wrong with a person if he's fearful or scared that he says I'll do this myself. I don't think the committee of the masjid will prevent this.
فالكل يتعاون.
So therefore everybody needs to, we all need to cooperate with each other.
يعني بعد الدرس اليوم تقول نحن نريد أن نقوم بنظافة المسجد وترتيب المسجد.
So for example after the lesson we say that today we want to clean and maintain the masjid.
كذلك إخواننا بناء المساجد الآن في هذه البلدان.
And also my brothers in terms of building the masajid in these days.
أنت تعرف أن دور المسجد في هذه الدول يعني دور عظيم جدا.
You know the important role of building the masajid in these places.
الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله.
الشيخ بن عثيمين may Allah mercy upon him.
جاء إليه الملك في بيته.
The king, he came to him in his house.
ورأى الملك بيت الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى بيت متواضع قديم جدا.
And the king, he saw the house of Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen, old and simple and very very simple and modest.
فقال الملك للشيخ رحمه الله.
So the king said to the to Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen, may Allah mercy upon him.
قال يا شيخ.
Oh Sheikh.
نريد نبني لك بيتا يعني قصر.
Oh Sheikh, we want to build you a house like a castle.
قال الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله.
الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله يسأل.
ماذا قال؟
What did he say?
لو قال لك الملك اليوم نبني لك قصر تقول لا واحد ما يكفي.
If a king came to you today and he said, I want to build for you a castle for you, you say one isn't enough for me.
أريد قصر.
I want a castle.
و يعني مول.
Shopping mall.
وعمارة.
And a big building.
ويعني مكان على البحر حتى نتنزه.
And also somewhere on the seafront so we can relax.
ويكفي هذا.
And then this is enough.
يعني الزهد طيب.
Because asceticism is good. To do without is good.
فقال له الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله.
But Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen رحمه الله said to him.
أعمر بيت الله.
That go and build the house of Allah.
بيتي أنا أبني.
My house, I will build it.
وأنت تبني بيوت الله.
But you go and build the house of Allah.
فأخواننا يعني أنتم مسؤولين الآن في هذه البلدان ونحن معكم عن بناء المساجد.
So we now, so you are now responsible for this, for building the masajid in this country, and we are with you.
تخاف أن هذا المال لا ينفق في المسجد أو كذا ماذا تصنع؟
If you're scared and fearful that this money that you're donating is not going to be given in the particular place that you want to spend in the way that you want in this masjid.
تأتي لهؤلاء وتقول أنا أشتري أسمنت حديد أخشاب ألمنيوم كذا. نعم.
So you come and you can say, look, I want to actually buy the cement or the plaster or the aluminium.
أو أعمل أنا أعمل في الجدران أو أعمل في كذا معكم.
Or me myself, I'm going to labor and work on the walls of the building.
كل واحد مني يستطيع أن يعمل شيء.
Every person is able to do something.
الشيخ بن باز رحمه الله أيضا قال له الملك نبني لك بيت.
Sheikh bin Baz rahimullah. Also the king came to him and he said, we're going to build a house for you.
And كان الشيخ بيت الشيخ من طابقين.
Because the house of the sheikh it was two stories.
وكان الشيخ يعني مع كبر السن لديه يعني ألم في الركبة ومرض في الركبة لا يستطيع الصعود الدرج.
And due to the old age of the sheikh, he wasn't able to, because of the illnesses and the weaknesses in his bones, he wasn't able to climb the stairs.
قالوا نبني لك بيت طابق واحد. يعني قصر.
So he said to him that we'll build for you a house which is only one floor, like a castle or like a bungalow.
ماذا قال؟
So what did the sheikh say?
لا أريد يعني طابقين مع مصعد.
Did he say
أو سلالم متحركة أو كذا؟
Did he
أو
say
سيارة بورش؟ نعم.
Did he say to him that no, I want a house with two stories, but with an escalator, an electric stairs, and I want a Porsche.
قال لا ما بقي في العمر شيء.
He said no because there's nothing remaining for my life.
يعني تبني لمن؟ أنا أموت.
Meaning who are you going to build for? Because I am going to die.
يا إخوانا هؤلاء العلماء لابد إحنا أن نقتدي بهم.
Oh my brothers, those scholars, we have to follow their example.
هم الطالب الآن قصر.
The intention or the desire of a student is now what? To build a castle.
وسيارة بورش.
To have a Porsche.
آيفون 5 أو 6.
To have an iPhone 6 or 5, 5 or 6.
وكذا وكذا وكذا.
And this and this and this.
إذا لم يزهد الطالب الآن من يزهد؟ تريد العوام يزهدوا؟
So if the student of knowledge is not going to do without and have a level of zuhud, asceticism, then who is it? The common people, they're going to do this?
أنا لا أدري من يزهد.
I don't know who is going to show this zuhud.
من يتعاون يا أخواننا على نشر العلم.
Who is the one who is going to cooperate with each other? Who are the people who will work in spreading knowledge?
من يتعاون معنا على بناء المساجد.
Who are going to cooperate with us in building the masajid?
نظافة المساجد.
Maintaining and cleaning the masajid.
أنا أرى الآن بعض الشباب هدانا الله إياه يشرب ويضع الكأس في أي مكان. نعم حتى الملابس يضعها في أي مكان. يأتي الناس إلى الصلاة العوام يقول هذا طلاب العلم. ما يمكن هذا يكون طلاب علم.
I see some students now, may Allah guide us and guide them, that when they drink something, they place their bottle anywhere in the masjid. When they take off their garment, they pray anywhere. And the people come and say, this is the student of knowledge.
جبريل عليه السلام دخل إلى مسجد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. لباس حسن. سمت. آدم. جالس جلسة المتأدب المتعلم ثم انصرف. ما ها سماه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم معلم. سماه معلم. نعم.
جبريل عليه السلام when he entered into the masjid of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he entered with the right type of clothes and the good clothes. He entered in with silence and good manners. He sat, he listened, and then he left. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم called him a معلم, a teacher.
يضع الكرسي في أي مكان ثم يترك الكرسي ويرجع.
So a person comes and he places the chair in any place and then he leaves the chair there and he leaves.
أكرمكم الله يضع النعال وكذا في أي مكان.
May Allah honor you. A person comes and he leaves his shoes anywhere in the pathway.
يأخذ كتاب من المكتب ويضعه في أي مكان.
A person takes a book from the library and puts it in another place.
شرب الشاي في صب الماء وأحيانا الطعام يكون على الأرض يتركه ويمشي.
A person, he drinks tea and he spills. Some of the food is on the floor and he leaves it alone.
يعني اليوم عندما دخلت وجدت الطعام موجود في الأرض.
So when I entered today, I found some food on the floor.
من يحمله؟
Who is going to pick it up?
هؤلاء.
Those cleaners, those brothers.
وأنت تأكل وتشرب وهم لا يأكل ولا يشرب ويحمل.
And you eat and you drink and they don't eat and they don't drink, but they're going to clear up your mess and your litter.
أمة واحدة أخوان.
One nation, one ummah, my brothers.
هل كان زمن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوجد شركة نظافة؟
At the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, was there a cleaning company, a company for cleaning?
شرطة.
Was there security and police?
مرور.
مرور.
ما أدري إيش يسمى مرور.
Traffic wardens.
المهم. هل كان هذا يوجد؟ كل واحد يعرف الذي له والذي عليه.
Was this around at that time? No. Every single person knew his right and his responsibility.
لكن الإشكال الآن إنه ما يوجد مسجد إلا ولابد في كل مسجد شيطان.
But the problem now is that there isn't a masjid except that there has to be a shaytan.
من الجن.
From amongst the jinn.
وشياطين من الإنس.
And also shayateen amongst the people.
يفسدون المساجد.
And they corrupt and spoil and litter the masajid.
وإذا انتهوا من المسجد انتقلوا للآخر.
And when they spoil and corrupt one masjid, they go and spoil and corrupt another masjid.
وشيطان الإنس أخطر من شيطان الجن.
And the shaytan amongst the men are more severe and more dangerous than the shayateen amongst the jinn.
لأن الشيطان الإنس تقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان شيطان الجن تقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الجن يذهب.
Because the shayateen amongst the jinn, when you say أعوذ بالله من الشياطين, then they go and they leave.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أما شيطان الإنس تقول أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يزيد.
As for the shayateen amongst men, if you say أعوذ, I seek refuge in Allah from the shayateen, they increase even more.
يا أخوانا, لابد أن يظهر أثر العقيدة علينا. نكون دعاة إلى الله بالعمل أعلى من القول أحيانا.
So, our brothers, the effects of our knowledge have to appear on us. Meaning, our actions are more louder than our words.
والبعض أيضا في الطعام الآن يكفي مثلا قرص واحد من الخبز. هو يأخذ ثلاثة أقراص. يأكل واحد ويرمي البقية.
Some people nowadays, one piece of bread is enough for him. And yet he takes three pieces of bread, eats one and throws two away.
لماذا؟
Why?
قال بلاش.
Because it's free.
خلي هؤلاء الجمعية عندهم أموال كثيرة.
Say the committee, leave them, they've got a lot of money.
أخوان, نحن نعمل لله لا للجمعية ولا غيره. جئنا والله يشهد أن لم نأتي لا للمسجد ولا للجمعية ولا لغيره. نسأل الله أن يجعل هذه الدورة خالصة لله.
Oh brothers, we came in order to seek the pleasure of Allah. We didn't come for the masjid or the masjid committee or the people. And we ask Allah to make our actions sincere for Him.
فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجزي خير الجزاء كل من كان سبب في إقامة هذه الدورات المباركة وأن يغفر لنا تقصيرنا.
And we ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to reward well those people or every single person who has been a reason for this dawra, this conference to come about, and we ask Allah to forgive our own shortcomings.
Wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.
Thank you.